Hello and welcome back to today's class. So in trigonometry, what we did till yesterday was values of ratios of certain angles. Now ratios are sine, cos, tan, and the angles are 30, 45, 60, 90 and 0 degrees. So we have learned yesterday how to find values of ratios of certain angles. Now we are going to use these values in solving sums. So let's see, these sums are very simple. Let's begin. So these are the values that definitely you all must have practiced yesterday, and as I said, you should be able to frame or create this table on your own. Now supposing you're given a sum sine 30 degrees plus cos 60 degrees. Very simple addition. Now we have to look into this table for values of sine 30 degrees. Nobody will know it by heart definitely. So 1 upon 2. We are going to write the value that we have found out. Sine 30 degrees is 1 upon 2 plus cos 60 degrees. Cos 60 degrees is also 1 upon 2. Now observe, denominator when it is same for two fractions, we draw a line and write that denominator and simply add numerators. Because there is plus sign, we are adding them. So 1 plus 1, this gives you 2 upon 2, and that means answer is 1. So simple. See, so it is required that you know these values correctly. Suppose these values are wrongly put, definitely you will not get same answer. So therefore, see that this table drawn or table created is perfect. Next, 2 cos 30 degrees. Now we have to find value of this. I am going very slowly so that you understand each and every different concept that is there in this chapter. 2 cos 30 degrees means 2 multiplied by cos 30 degrees. What is cos 30 degrees? Root 3 upon 2. So we have substituted value of cos 30 degrees, root 3 upon 2, and now is equal to 2 in the numerator, 2 in the denominator can be cancelled, and what you get is root 3. So when it is a coefficient or a constant which is there along with the ratio of an angle, all you have to do is simply multiply, because there is no sign between these two, that means sign is multiplication. Sometimes it can be square of the value, sine square 30 degrees. Please note, this is the way square is written in these kind of sums. So what does this square mean? It simply means whatever is the value of sine 30 degrees, 1 upon 2, square of that. So 1 upon 2 square is equal to 1 square upon 2 square. This gives you 1 upon 4. That's the answer. So when it is square sign, it is not put after the angle. It is put after the ratio and we find value of that particular ratio and put the square outside the bracket. Remember, bracket here is important. Suppose you don't put the bracket. Let's see what happens. So bracket is not put. It means square is only of 1, not of 2. Okay, and you will not arrive at this particular step then. You will arrive at 1 square upon 2, which will not give you this answer. Okay, so it is very important that you put a bracket whenever there is a fraction's square. Next, 5 tan square 60 degrees. So what do we do here? 5 multiplied by, what is tan 60 degrees? Tan 60 degrees over here. This is the value root 3. So I will now write root 3 square. And what is root 3 square? 5 multiplied by 3. So which gives you 5 threes are 15. Okay, so I am taking single ratio for you to understand how to do the operations in these kind of sums. Next sum you have sine square 30 degrees plus cos 45 degrees. Now one term is having square of a ratio, another term does not have. Well, now you know how to go about it. Sine 30 degrees is 1 upon 2. And square of that, as we just saw, that a bracket is to be put, plus what is cos 45 degrees? Please note here it is not square, just cos 45. So cos 45 is 1 upon root 2. So you get square of 1 upon 2 is 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon root 2. Now you have to add these two fractions. Look at the denominator and find LCM. And whenever like this kind of totally two different terms are there, one is irrational, one is a rational, then LCM will automatically be the product. So 4 root 2 will be the LCM. And let's see, 4 root 2. So what is the numerator over here to be multiplied with? It will be multiplied with what is not there. So root 2 will be multiplied here. And here 4 root 2. So here it will be 4. So what will be our next step? Root 2 plus 4. That's all. You can leave it at this step. If you cannot further do any working on this, this would be the answer. So don't worry, these are rough sums which I have just written randomly. In textbook there will be sums where you will get a proper answer. So let's see a textual sum. Observe this sum: cos square 45 degrees plus sine square 30 degrees. So when it is cos square 45 degrees, we require value of cos 45. Cos 45 is 1 upon root 2. So 1 upon root 2, the whole bracket square, because it is written square over here. Similarly, sine 30 degrees. Sine 30 degrees is 1 upon 2. But square is mentioned, so I will write down square of the entire bracket since it's a fraction. Now square of 1 upon root 2. 1 square is 1. Root 2 square is 2. Please see, root 2 multiplied by root 2 will give you 2. And therefore, square of root 2 is 2 plus 1 square is 1. And 2 square is 4. Now it is important to find LCM of 2 and 4. LCM of 2 and 4 is 4. And once we have got LCM as 4, look at the denominator here. 2, how many is 4? टू टू ज़ा, फोर हाउ मेनी ज़ा इज़ फोर, फोर वन ज़ा, सो मल्टीप्लाई विथ दैट फैक्टर टू द न्यूमरेटर, टू टू ज़ा फोर, सो आई मल्टीप्लाई न्यूमरेटर विथ टू, फोर वन ज़ा फोर, सो आई मल्टीप्लाई दिस न्यूमरेटर विथ वन, सो वट डू वी गेट, वन इंटू टू टू, वन इंटू वन वन इज इक्वल टू थ्री अपॉन फोर एंड दैट्स द फाइनल आंसर. सो इट्स नथिंग, सब्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ वैल्यूज, स्क्वेरिंग देम, एडिंग देम विथ करेक्ट एलसीएम स्टेप एंड देन यू कैन नेवर गो रॉन्ग इन दीज काइंड ऑफ सम्स. सो इफ अ स्क्वेयर टर्म इज देयर देन वैल्यू गेट्स स्क्वेयर्ड, दैट्स ऑल दैट यू हैव टू नोट. नेक्स्ट, 3 साइन 90 डिग्रीज माइनस 2 साइन 30 डिग्रीज. नाउ साइन 90 डिग्रीज इज 1 एंड प्लीज नोट दिस इज नॉट स्क्वेयर. सो 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय साइन 90 डिग्रीज 1 माइनस 2 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय साइन 30 डिग्रीज. साइन 30 डिग्रीज इज 1 अपॉन 2. I have purposely put bracket because there are too many operations and they are very close, and let these be into separate brackets, then calculation becomes easy. So 3 into 1, 3 minus 2 and 2 gets cancelled minus 1. So what do you get? 2. So it was not square. Please note that. So it was just a simple. Now all along we have done sums with just one term or two terms like this. There can be sums with three terms. It's again very, very simple. Please note I have added one term plus cos 0 degrees. Cos 0 degrees is 1. So 3 minus 1 plus 1, and then what will be the answer? 3. So even with 3 terms there is no need to worry. Solution is very, very simple. So let's continue with more such sums.